So we have a new approach in multiple sclerosis where we utilize agents that are given in short treatment courses, lead to a reduction of immune cells, and ultimately will lead to repopulation of these immune cells. The whole concept behind these treatments is the fact that we try to reset the immune system in multiple sclerosis in a direction of a non-self-aggressive and non-self-reactive immune system. The agents that we have been studying in that particular area are Lemtrada, alemtuzumab. We have also more recently been studying cladribine, that has not yet come to the market in the United States, but is licensed in Europe. This agent has been studied in two phase three trials and one extension trial. The first of the phase three trial was the Clarity trial. The second one was the Oracle trial, which was a trial with patients at the time of a first event treated with cladribine. The Oracle trial, that's the CIS trial, has been the trial with a quite significant reduction of the risk of patients to progress to clinically definite multiple sclerosis. So patients either having a second event. The trial has also shown that it delays the likelihood of patients having a next MRI lesion, so the 2010 McDonald criteria or the 2005 McDonald criteria. So this is a new approach towards the treatment of multiple sclerosis, where we give agents that take away autoreactive immune cells and will enable a recrudescence, a growing up of an immune system that is not self-reactive. Obviously, these agents are associated with reduction of immune cells, and so an infection risk is a potential concern. As we look at the cladribine development, this infection risk was higher during a relatively short period of time when patients had low lymphocyte counts. In general, with cladribine, the lymphocyte counts are lowish, but grade 3 and grade 4 lymphopenias have only been observed in a small number of patients. Cladribine is dosed orally. It is weight-based dosed in 10 milligram tablets that is then adjusted to weight of patients. The cumulative dose given in two treatment cycles is 3.5 kilograms over 2 years. So, like any other trial, cladribine has had positive results both in the CIS that I talked about, but also in relapsing remitting patients. There we have the Clarity trial. The Clarity trial has been a standard trial and has also had a long-term extension of its original study. One of the interesting things about the cladribine development program is the fact that initially this product was submitted to the FDA based on one trial. In that particular trial, the Clarity trial, there was a small oncologic risk, which then gave concern. Since then, obviously, the Oracle trial has been completed and also the extension trial of the Clarity trial has been completed. This oncologic risk has not repeated itself in the larger cohort, and because the product development was interrupted, we have now long-term follow-up for cladribine, so up to 5 or 6 years after the actual dosing, and no oncologic risk has at this point in time emerged.